IG's turn to ban.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another Dota commentary done here by Vash. I'm going to cast Natas Vincer versus Invictus Gaming, and this is game number one of Alienware Cup. This has been played 2 days ago on a Wednesday afternoon, or I guess Wednesday night, regarded in China. And it has been quite a furious game, and there is going to be obviously one reason I'm casting this or recasting this from a replay. It's basically because I'm seeing Natas Vincer play some interesting game right here, and I just want to go ahead and talk about that in a few moments once they picked up their heroes and you can see what exactly I do mean. Now, Natas Vincer has not been playing, I guess, too extraordinarily well against the Chinese teams in this tournament so far. However, they have shown that they are on the verge of improving. They won one game against Orange, and against Orange, and they're getting there, I suppose. So it's gonna be a blast to see how they evolve, and they're gonna have their next games on the 30th of June, by the way. So be aware of that and tune in, obviously, when there's gonna be a game hosted by Beyond the Summit. Okay, so let's just go into the bans and picks right now, and it's gonna be a Nyx here for Invictus Gaming being picked up first. After there is a Wisp ban, a Darkseer ban, obviously, and a Batrider ban, which is quite naturally as well. Visage is being banned by Natas Vincer because he's being played by all the Chinese teams, all the Asian teams, so very frequently, and you know, Navi just don't want to put up with that shit anymore, I do believe, and that's one of the big reasons why they are banning this. They couldn't handle the Visage pickup by the Chinese games in the previous games, and you know, so right now that's what they're doing. They're just saying, okay, definitely do not want to play against this. Anyhow, so as we're seeing right now, we do have Rubick being picked up by Invictus Gaming, which is obviously a good counter against Nuke's Assassin and Puck, simply because of the reason that he's able to steal a lot of spells from those two heroes. He's able to punish opponents in general with his telekinesis, so he's a good tri-lane hero as well. He works well with Lifestealer. With the telekinesis drawback, you can basically just secure a really nice open wounds, which has been nerfed quite heavily. I mean, it's 200 AoE, and obviously it's hard to get off as a Lifestealer, but if you have Rubick telekinesing and target back, you're not gonna have any problem to initiate on anybody after that. We do see Gyrocopter and Alchemist being banned out right now. And Natas Vincer, if they ban Gyrocopter out, they normally are not playing him on Khavost. However, this game, there's gonna be something very special about the picks and about the playstyle of Natas Vincer. Now, after they have been slacking a few games and losing a few games in this Alienware Cup, they apparently decided to just rotate around and try some new roles, try some new game plan, new laning. Maybe Khavost wasn't feeling that well on that day, and he was like, okay, I need to try something else or something. I don't know what's going to happen on Sunday, because that's when Navi's going to go up against in the playoffs. And it's going to count right there. They definitely have to win that game to proceed and advance. Otherwise, they are out of this tournament. And it's about $60,000 overall prize pool. I mean, this is quite a big tournament they are stacking in while they are in China. Now, the next ban, Natas Vincer might be looking to ban out another strong support for Invictus Gaming, something that can follow up with a Rubick or even a good mid laner who's going to shut down a Puck or is going to be as mobile and, you know, can provide maybe a Lifestealer in Fest Bump, which would be in this case, I suppose, something like a Storm Spirit, maybe a Queen of Pain, since Ferrari is a really nice Queen of Pain player. He's, you know, he has been playing her for a while now and then all the time. I mean, obviously Ferrari, he can play any given mid hero. I do believe that Invictus Gaming is going to go ahead and maybe ban out TA in the next banning phase, or in the next ban of theirs, simply because TA is one of those counters against the Lifestealer that works really well. I mean, you know, Lifestealer is a single target damage output dealer. He just right clicks one target and he has no spells to remove anything else. He has no AoE damage except for the Infest. And TA, you know, that's one of those heroes with the Refraction. What is the Nyx going to do? He's going to hit against you and he's gonna try to hammer you down, but overall, I mean, the TA has Refraction charges and she's gonna be totally fine, so no problem right there. We do see Anti-Mage actually being banned out by Natas Vincer, and I guess the main reason in this case is there is a Puck on the field, there is a Lina now on the field, they picked that up right there, while we see Invictus Gaming actually banning out the Clockwork as an offlaner, which is, you know, a decent choice, but in this game, Navi has something totally different on their mind. We do see Lina being picked up right now for Natas Vincer. Now, usually you would say, okay, I'm gonna see a Puck, mid lane by Dendi. We're gonna see Alina on a support by maybe Kurokai or Puppy. We're gonna see Nuke's Assassin on Kurokai or Puppy, you know, those two supports. Really, really two supports that work really well with each other. I mean, we're gonna have an Impale, we're gonna have a Lightstrike Airy that's just gonna hit and connect at any given moment. And that just leaves you to pick up any carry really to be in a lane, just to get some damage output done and get some kills picked up, and also a really nice safe lane farm. Now, Nature's Prophet being picked up right now by Invictus Gaming. That's definitely a Chinese hero. I mean, you can go into woods, you can go into offlane, depending on what lane you're against. I mean, in this case, probably going to rotate into the woods fairly soon, since against Alina, against Nyx Assassin, there's no real way to do anything in a lane, to creep skip, to pull creeps, to do anything in that direction. Not going to happen in this game for sure, since there's so much damage output and so much burst damage by Alina and Nyx Assassin that it's really hard to pull that one off. So, you know, Nature's Prophet going to be a nice addition because he has that nice capability of teleporting around the map, map presence everywhere, and he's just going to be raging upon the map. Once Lifesteal hits 6, once he gets some items up himself, basically a Shadow Blade, a Midas. After that, you know, you could see Lifesteal and Prophet appearing anywhere on the map, and that's why I'm saying there might be another solo mid here for Invictus Gaming that is going to be really mobile, and with that going to secure 3 main ganks on top of the map anywhere at any given point, which adds a lot of pressure to Nettles Vincer. However, we do see a Windrunner being picked up right now. That's going to be an offlane we haven't seen so much in recent time, simply because Windrunner has faded out of the meta trend, and she's, you know, she with Windrunner level 1, she's not able to stand very well on the lanes, because any given tri-lane support here, like Telekinesis on Rubick, you know, you can't really stay in lane. I mean, even if you have a lane ward, which is going to get dewarded most likely, or a wood ward, I suppose, for Windrunner, you can't stand there, because once you activate Windrunner, that's the point when Rubick is going to use the Telekinesis, not any point earlier, and for that, he's going to be able to, you know, kill a Windrunner off with two more supports. In this case, we see a Silencer being picked up by IG. Oh man, what a pick right there. We're going to see if that's going to be a mid-hero Silencer, or if it's going to be a support hero Silencer. I do believe laning him with a Rubick and a Lifestealer is not the worst choice, especially against the Windrunner. In this case, you can just use her second spell. You can just use Silencer's second spell, so that whenever she uses a spell, she's obviously going to be silenced, not going to use any more spells, and then just follow up with the Curse of the Silence, maybe killing her off when she's running away, still getting the kill on her. However, we do see Viper being picked up for Nattus Vincer here. Holy effing shit. So that's what I'm talking about. I just saw the picks. Just saw the picks of Nettles Vincer, and that's why I'm actually wanted to cast this, even though this has happened 2 days ago. Man, this is going to be really interesting. Seeing a Viper being last picked by Nettles Vincer obviously leaves you to guess that this is going to be a Viper that is going to carry the fuck out of you. But we're going to see how far this is going to work. Obviously, Viper is a nice counter pick against the Lifestealer. Do not forget that Viper is one of those heroes that can slow any given melee carry. Any, you know, her orbs and her ultimate just really work on the Lifestealer, and I don't know if Lifestealer can really carry as he pleases if there's a Viper in the field gonna focus down on him and just make sure he's not gonna be able to right click with the normal attack speed he normally has. And yeah, we're gonna see how that's gonna work out, if she's gonna be dominating the map or not. Now, obviously, we do have Na'Vi versus Invictus Gaming. That means Invictus Gaming, you know, that is a prestigious game, prestigious team. They have been playing against Na'Vi on and off here and there. And, you know, one of those games you really remember is probably, you know, International 2, most likely. And those were some really intense games. And we saw that Nettles Vincer has been able to overcome Invictus Gaming here and there. But overall, Invictus Gaming obviously has a lot of experience, works really well together, and is such a strong team. So yeah, let's just wait for the last pick. Definitely not going to be a Cancer Lancer or Beastmaster here for IG. They have been banned out by Nettles Vincer. I do believe Sansa is not going to go into mid lane, so we're going to see a mid lane pick coming out of Invictus Gaming right here. And I'm using a lot of time right now, 25 seconds of reverse time as far as I'm concerned. So Brewmaster is going to be the last pickup right here. So they're going to lane this hero in mid by Ferrari. Going to be played by Ferrari, obviously. We're going to see Faith on the Silencer. That means that we're going to have a support Silencer as well. Oopsie daisy. There we go. Alright. Set and go. Funnik is gonna be heading towards top lane on that Viper, maybe going safe lane carry here. We're gonna see Dandy on the puck in mid lane, and now this is interesting right here. We're gonna see Puppy on the Nuke's Assassin heading towards bottom lane. We're gonna see Kurakai picking up the Windrunner right there. Maybe support Windrunner and Havost on the carry. Lina, I don't know what we're gonna see here. You're gonna see it in just a few moments. Definitely an interesting try lane right here. A lot of burst damage is gonna come out of Na'Vi. We do see Lina picking up wards, so that almost leaves you to guess that she's gonna go for support support Lina right here. So we do see a Atrian scouting out the lanes of Na'Vi. Not good for Na'Vi, because that means that IG can totally prepare for this mentally and physically. Gonna maybe set up some wards, just gonna secure the rune as well. Kurokai picks up a ring of protection and some regeneration items. That means that he might even be going in towards a farmed Windrunner right there. I don't even know how to say that, but Zhao, as we do see a nice D-ward coming off of them right here in this very moment, so well played by them. Anyway, so Zhao is going to be playing on the Nyx. I really wonder, Zhao, I don't even know Chinese names. Six is going to be playing on the Rubick, as he telekinesis Puppy back onto high ground. That means Puppy might even go down here with the first blood. We're going to see if it's going to be enough. Open Wounds has been used, and Puppy needs to skill his Carapace now to get out. That means there's not going to be an Impale level 1 for another while here, and that's going to really cripple their tri-lane right now of Natus Vincer. We're going to see Faith on the Silencer right here as the secondary support. Mid lane, Ferrari on the Brewmaster against Dandy on the puck. Interesting that Dandy just was probably a misclick right here, orbing himself onto high ground, and gonna be an interesting battle right here. I do believe that Brewmaster and Puck both have the same amount of impact, as we do see a Curse of the Silence on Puppy and on Kurokai. Kurokai, however, used his power shot, and Puppy can use his Carapace, so that is actually a nice spell to just dodge that mana leak of the Silencer with his Curse of the Silence. As we do see a little bit of engagement right here, Havos harassing with the Light Strike area. Now on top lane, we do see that Viper is going to go against the Nature's Prophet. They're going to both stand in a really nice manner. And 3-man Curse of the Silence once again. Puppy is just using his one spell. Kurokai is not using any spell as it seems. And they're just, okay, level 1. Let's just chill and not use more mana right now. YYF on the Nature's Prophet is going to... yeah, you know, have a decent time on top lane, I do believe. However, we do have Viper, obviously, with the possibility to last it really well with her Nether Toxin, and Nether Toxin is a strong spell. Obviously at some point she's going to be able to last it or outlast it a Nature's Prophet. However, he's sitting at 6-1 while the Viper is sitting at 4-1 right now, and or 5-1 right now, so that means that, you know, Prophet is keeping up well. And if he's going to go for face boots, which might be the right choice in this case, he's going to add a lot of lasted damage to his lane, might be able to use some nicer ras and, you know, keep Viper sort of down slash be as farmed as she is. And it's gonna come down ultimately to how well Na'Vi can execute team fights against the Panda, who is a really nice pickup by IG, simply because he can stand very well in team fights. He has that primal split, and with a primal split he's gonna be able to just dodge every single burst damage or a lot of burst damage done by Na'Vi. Gonna wreak havoc with his stun, with his Cyclops, obviously, Cyclone I mean. Again, harassment from Curse of the Silence here on Na'Vi. However, it's not draining that much, as you can see. So, you know, they're losing a little mana, but it's not a huge, huge deal. Dandy right now in mid lane against his counterpart Ferrari. They were once one of the strongest mid laners on Earth for, you know, or I guess during International two times, International 2, last year, 2012. However, I do believe that Dandy has maybe gotten a little, you know, slightly weaker. Because there's so much competition right now, you can't say that Dandy is one of the top mid laners anymore, as well as you can't say it about over IG Ferrari. There's just so many good other mid laners, like S4 for example, like Fata of Mousesports, all really good mid laners. Anyways, Ferrari really pressuring Dandy right now, and he needs to care, as we do see some, maybe some initiation. Havos is going to be fine right now. Faith is just going to mana up right now with a nice clarity. Right now, when you look at the gold graph, it does appear that Dire is actually having a nice advantage. They're controlling the laning quite well. We do see that Nyx has only 6 lasses, while we see that Kurokai on the Windrunner has 10 with 70 nice. So that's working out really well for them. Mid lane Ferrari is sitting at 10 assets versus Dendy with 12 and 6. So, you know, he's doing fine right now. He's going to be fine overall in general anyways. We do see an offensive port against Fnatic because he got a lot of tower harassment right there. Really nice play by YYF. Definitely not going to be enough though in this case. And Fnatic is going to heal up right away. And he's going to get face boots first. So he's going to have the advantage in this lane. YYF, what is he going to get? YYF is just getting a bottle. Interesting choice right there. Just going to go for the mana harassment. Mana advantage and probably secure the runes which they have or which they can with the wards, and there's no chance for Na'Vi to contest those unless they scout them and hog them like they do right now. But unluck is coming right there for Na'Vi, so that means it's going to be on top lane, and that means YYF is definitely going to use it in just a second, going to port there, going to grab it or even just walk there, as we do see Khavos going down to first but being out of position right there, isolated from the rest of Na'Vi, and definitely nothing that you want to be happening. And once again, Puppy is being harassed here out onto the cliff right there, and this should not be possible. Volvo, please fix. I do believe that they wanted to fix this, and you cannot do this normally, but apparently there's still some bug right there because that should not happen. Puppy is going to be out of the game for a while right here, and he's definitely cursing this game right now because he got telekinesed up onto high ground. And Khavos, just a few moments ago, totally out of position right there, trying to rotate in while we did see that the rest of his team was on the left side. That was a bit of a miscommunication right there. Khavos now gonna use his Dragon Slave to harass Faith away. He's gonna miss it though, so that's not really what you want to do as well. Let's just take a quick peek into mid lane. Dendy obviously having his bottle, has his null talisman up. We do see Ferrari going aggressive right now. He wants to hit that stump, is gonna get out, however, that Dendy is just using his Illusory Orb really well, kiting around. And YYF top lane, only a ball right now. You could really say that he's getting out carried out CS right now on top lane, because that face boots and that nether toxin is doing a lot of work for Fnatic right now. Prophet is not even staying in the lane really anymore. He's farming in woods, as we do see Khavos rotating towards top lane. I guess they're gonna play this now the old traditional way. We do still see, oh man, Puppy, poor old Puppy, he's just standing there for a long, long while. And now we're gonna see a teleport being shipped out to him, and he's just out of the game right now. That means Kurkai, actually, that is a big deal for IG here. They were losing this lane by quite a bit since they didn't get CS and nothing. But right now we do have free farm on a lifesteal. He caught up pretty well. He's at 26 right now, although we do still have Kurkai on 25 last hits. But still, he's getting farm right now, and also he's getting their supports are getting farm because they can just, or they could just pull and stack those creeps for about 1.5 minutes that Puppy was basically stuck on here, and he still doesn't have his teleport. What is going on there, Na'Vi? My Jesus. This Puppy is definitely just watching and spectating right now. That is not what they wanted. We're gonna see probably on the grass that they're losing it right now. Yeah, we see that is that one. That is a one steep inclination towards IG right there. As we do see it go on Kurka, he's getting body blocked a little bit right here, but he's gonna be fine. Puppy TP just a second ago, it's gonna land an impale on the ground, however, nobody's gonna walk into it, and that means Kurkai is gonna go back, gonna be blocked by the creeps right there, gonna hurry towards base to regenerate up. He has his face boots up and a ring of Basilisk, but as we can see right now, this tri lane now is working really well for IG. What a pity for Na'Vi, as we do see Khavos making some good time out of his mate's absence, gonna harass and farm some creeps. Getting his boots up, that is definitely a key item right now on him. We do have Faith on the boots, we do have 6th on boots. So that means that right now IG, if you just compare the supports, they are definitely ahead right now. Yep, for sure. But Khavos is gonna have his boots up in just a moment after the next last hit. Puppy has a smoke and he's not sitting in a really nice condition here. He's only level 2, and man, that telekinesis on the spot right here broke Na'Vi's early game completely. I would even say that right now Na'Vi needs to somehow cope with this, find a way to get back into the game, because it's going to be Kuroki on the offlane right now, and honestly that's not a nice thing to do, because he was being the farm tri-lane carry and slash carry, I suppose. You know, sort of like a Darkseer with a tri-lane. Now he has to farm up with a ring of Basilisk with his power shot, and he is only a partial level 2, so not a good time for him. And as we said already, there's going to be a Faith harassing him. There's going to be There's going to be obviously telekinesis harassment once he uses Windrunner. He's not going to get out, as we're seeing right now. Kukri has to run out. He can't use Windrunner next. Now he's using it. He has to use it, but that's why he's going to go down. There's the open wounds, and that is just an easy kill on Kurokai. Kurokai is going to use some harassment right there with the power shot. Going to deal some damage, as we do see a nice rotation here of the whole rest of the Navi team. They're going to force top lane, which is a nice trade to do. They're losing one tower. Right here for that kill on Kurokai, and we will see if they're going to be able to push this tower out. I do believe that might be not enough since YYF, oh, he does have enough mana since he has his bottle. You see the first rotation right here from Denli, and I do believe they wanted that this for sure. And let's see if there's going to be any initiation right now. Is Denli going to make a go? I don't think so. Nope, he should definitely not do that. And Kurokai is back into the lane right now. They're just pushing more Navi right here, definitely adding more and more pressure, and they're gonna have to back right now. That's what they're doing. So attack. Good choice. It has no arms to defend. Radiant's top tower is under attack. We do see that there's 2,500 gold up on the Funnic, and Funnic sitting at 70 lasses right now. That is huge. That is a lot of farm right now. Net worth wise, he's at 4,000 compared to the Knicks at 3,400. Means that Navi's primary carries are definitely ahead right now. We do see mid lane more or less even. Kurokai is still having a little bit more money than in profit, so that's still working out okay for him and for Navi there. But I do believe that Nakes getting into the game, which they had shut down for a while, that is a big deal, and he might be coming back at Navi in just a few moments. Sitting at 45 lasses right now, just idling on this lane. Going stacking in the casual bracer. We'll see if he's gonna go for the drums build and then opting into an armlet or a Yasha, or if he's just gonna skip the drums right now and go into the straight armlet and just picking up a casual bracer, which he wanted for a possible return of the tri-lane. Kurokai now opting to go into mid lane, getting some nice creep kills up right here on him. As we do see everybody here, IG Ferrari is gonna get shackled up, really nice done by, nice job by them, but he will still have his ultimate. Is there gonna be enough chain lock? There's the silence by Denli. Denli is gonna get out after a last hit on the Brewmaster. He's gonna go down, really well played by Navi here, using everything. Shackle, Lightstrike Array, an Impale follow up, then the silence with a Waning Rift by Puck. Really, that was extremely well done. Six here in big troubles right here. Gonna go down, however, after the Prophet is there as well. Definitely too much for him to handle. Getting a kill on a support, I guess that's something. But YYF here getting nice experience by killing that Viper. And he's gonna be coiled up here right now, but he's just gonna walk out right now after using his Sprout. There's a dual TP, but however, there's a rotation in by Puppy. So they're getting the really quick kill on Prophet right here. That was well played by them. Puppy, is he gonna get out? I do believe he's not gonna get out, but maybe he can use his Carapace, or maybe he can just deny himself two creeps. There we go, creeps are there. He's killed by the Radiant, well played by him. That's more or less half of the deny, and that means that overall Navi getting some nice kills out of IG right now, and we're gonna see. Yeah, gold wise Dire still being quite ahead of the rest of the team, simply because of Funnic farming up like a champ right now, and Ferrari still yet to use his primary split, couldn't do so in the last quote-unquote team fight while he got ganked. And yeah, we'll see how this is gonna commence. I mean, 2,000 experience is already quite a big deal on 11 minutes. That means that the supports are under level. We're not gonna see an ultimate. Actually, we're gonna see an ultimate out of Lina right here, not out of Nuke's Assassin yet, though. However, while we're just seeing that, obviously the whole team of IG has their ultimates up. Oh, I see Ferrari getting harassed here once again. He's probably gonna use his ultimate, or is he? There's a silence by. Silence are being used globally, so nothing to follow up here for Navi. Not quite sure what that was about. There's a smoke in from Kurokai and Denli. Denli gonna go in with a Lugia up. Waning Rift right there. Ferrari, however, is probably gonna use his ultimate. Nice shackle shot by Kurokai. Are they gonna bring down 6? They need to bring down 6. 6 has not stolen anything right now. He's gonna run for his life. It's gonna go down. Funnic now is gonna be stunned up. Gonna be clamped and hammered down by 3 of the pandas, and now he's gonna be Cyclone right there. They're gonna definitely just, yep, there we go, gonna kill him right there. YYF supported and rotated in there as well. This is a 1-for-1 trade, definitely once again not a trade that Navi wants to do or wants to be making, simply because Viper trading a Viper against a support, nope, disapprove. I disapprove, but yeah. Still, Navi is really adding some pressure right now on IG, and right now Ferrari does have his cooldown 150 seconds more on his primary split. That means that, you know, that is the point where Na'Vi needs to be fighting right now. We do still have Lina with her Laguna Blade up, so that's a lot of burst damage. We do have Puppy almost hitting level 6 right there. He just needs a little bit of mana. YYF pouring top, trying to pressure it, but Funding is on top of this, is here right away. He actually went for the mechanism. That is an interesting tactic right here by Na'Vi. They want to add pressure, they want to fight, and they want to really make it count and get some kills out of this. Dendi right now is on bottom lane right here. Six is gonna steal from Dendi. Dendi actually feeding, unfortunately, the illusory orb towards Six. That's a lot of damage coming out of the Ruby right there. He's gonna be able to telekinesis. Level 3 Fate Bolt, dealing a lot of damage with a level 4 illusory orb. Man, now they have to really care on this bottom lane. But Dendi still looks like he wants to make something happen here, but I do believe he can't because Viper's not there. And yeah, we still have Puppy here in mid lane. Really. Gonna have some nice rotation coming out of Na'Vi here to actually make something happen. Because Zoe is definitely being sitted up till nowhere right now. What does he have right now? He almost has his armlet up. There's only Blades of Attack missing for him right now. So that's another 150 gold for him. And then he's going to have it. And that means Armlet next is going to be able and ready to teamfight. Ferrari almost has his ultimate back up right now. And he's at almost 11-11. And at 11-11, obviously he's going to push his ultimate ability up by so much. Gonna be a problem for Na'Vi, but they're gonna get the next tower here quite uncontested, actually. So a lot of money going into the account of Na'Vi right here. Yep, we do see exactly that. 2000 gold advantage right now for Na'Vi. XP wise, yeah, they're still kind of behind. I mean, obviously it's 5-4 for IG. IG farmed a little bit better. Puppy is still trying to catch up with that experience disadvantage he has by getting pulled up onto this high cliff right here. And yeah, he's level 6 now, so that's actually the start for him to actually achieve something. But alone, he's not going to find any kill. Vendetta's going to be here another 4-5 seconds. He's going to go on YYF. There we go. Carapace is going to actually make a lot of damage towards Nash's Prophet, since he's going to hit that Prophet ultimate towards Puppy's Carapace. And Dendi rotating in here, getting the kill right there. Now they're going to rotate towards bottom lane, going to try to actually get a kill out of it. However, Prophet is only down 20 seconds, so he's going to be back into the fight right then. We also do have primal spirit up by Brewmaster right now. So, man, Na'Vi needs to really care to not misplay this right now. There we go, Lightstrike area being cast into the woods right there, off face. Kavos out of position once again. Is he going to use his Laguna Blade? He definitely needs to use it on somebody. He's going to use it on face. No, he's not. He didn't use any spells. However, we did see that Na'Vi actually killed off the Rubick on the backhand, as well as the Brewmaster. Nice, nice job by them, because Brewmaster was not able to use his Primal Spirit once again because of the stun lockdown by Na'Vi, as we do seeing that right now. Faith is sort of getting harassed down. Kurukai has no mana right now. He's gonna get mecha up, however, and that means that nobody's gonna die right here. Or is Faith gonna die? Yeah, he's gonna die for sure. Dendi is here, is gonna attack even more. That means that's like, oh, missing the waiting rift right there, but it's gonna be enough damage with the last hits. And overall, a nice trade for Na'Vi, getting a 3-for-1 trade, I do believe. And you know, 3-for-1 trade definitely would eat that at any point as Na'Vi. They're sitting at 8-6 right now. That means they're also going to have a nice increase by experience, as we have seen it. It's going to get evened out even more right now. Havos right now, not on top of his game, unfortunately, multiple times out of position. However, good job by him kiting around two heroes, basically. That means that most of IG was split from each other, 2 and 3 heroes. And that gave Na'Vi the chance to burst down the Brewmaster, burst down the Rubick, and yeah. Worked out for them in this case. We're gonna see some D wards here, or no D wards. They just see the ward, maybe gonna smoke up because they know there's a ward right there, and just abuse it overall, as reducing engagement on Zhao. Zhao, however, is just gonna turn around and gonna go and find it, because he knows there is a rotation in from Ferrari. Ferrari picked up his dagger. He's gonna go in with his ultimate in just a few seconds, or is he? No, he's not right now. Oh, huge engagement here by Dendi. Dendi with a nice dream call, nice damage going out. Zhao already dead, had to buy back right here. Silencer is still dead. Puppy needs to rotate back. The question is Kurukai gonna get out? No, Kurukai is gonna take a fall for this, most likely. Or is there gonna be rotation? I don't think Puppy needs to go in here. Puppy needs to go back. There's a cycle on Puppy. That means Puppy is gonna go down as well. Really, that was unnecessary, my friend. You're gonna die now, in vain, basically. Nice DWARDs here coming out of Chavos. They're gonna smoke up in there, probably gonna make a go. Then yeah, Vir's gonna take the long the short route while Lina's gonna try to rotate from. Wow, nice three-man waiting rift right here from Na'Vi. Na'Vi, however, Denny in trouble. He's gonna get burst down really fast. That means he's gonna die here, no problem. Even though he has a dagger, estimating what he can do right there. And Funding now might be in problems as well. He only has a point boost up right now. No real damage from him. He's only tanking with the mechanism. Chavos is gonna go on IG Zhao. Zhao is gonna get burst down by so much. He's gonna toggle his armor. He's gonna survive by that. We do have Windrunner stolen for Rubik right now. Another kill not going into the direction of Na'Vi. However, they're gonna get Ferrari. Ferrari being left behind by his team right here, so that means that is the next kill for them. Run, little bottom tower, run. Anyway, Na'Vi doing a nice job right now of controlling the game. They're getting back into the game more and more, getting some nice kill trades off. The problem, however, is, in my opinion, that Prophet and Nakes late game, they're gonna hurt a lot, and I don't know if Funnik is enough to deal with them right now. He also has opted for sort of tanky build right there with a mechanism, with a point booster, but that also means that he's not gonna have any real damage output anytime soon. He's gonna go for an Aghanim Scepter just to use it every 15 seconds. That's what I'm thinking right now, because he has picked up the point booster. Not quite sure if that is worth it actually, but we will see, obviously. 12 seconds. That means he can use it multiple times in a fight, as we do see Puppy dropping down here, being sort of out of position, being lifted back with telekinesis, and that means that this middle tower here is gonna go down, and IG getting their second tower right now, as we have seen that top tower has been taken by them as well a while ago apparently. Yeah, not too long ago. Kukai has his 4 staff up right now, 1400 in the bank, probably gonna opt for something like a sheepstick since mechanism is already on the field. With Funnik. Funnik already has the Ogre Club right now. Is he gonna go for a PKB? No, he's gonna probably finish his Iron Scepter. Chavos, my friend, you really need to level up your gaming right now. Not a lot seen from Chavos right now. He's seeing a 1-2-1. Participation from him right now is not as good as it could be. But, you know, if he's going to be able to get a nice Laguna Blade off and some nice Light Strike areas and multiple ones in the fight, we might see some turnarounds here for him. As we do see Funnik being totally out of position, gonna get go down here for sure. And Dendy, you need to care, because if you're gonna get Cyclone right now, you're gonna die most likely. There we go, Cyclone right here on Dendy. Dendy needs to blink out immediately. He's just gonna spam that blink. Is he gonna get out? That's a big... Yep, he's gonna get out with a blink. Are you gonna chase him? No, they're not. We did see a Silencer ultimate being used by IG right here. Not quite sure if that was the right decision. Not... Puppy wanted to hit some damage right here with his Vendetta. He's not gonna do so. He's just gonna hit an impale right there. Sentry being dropped by Chavos right here. So we do see Silencer picking up his threats already, man. He's getting tanky as a Silencer, and obviously the more intelligence he steals, the more damage he does with his Glaives of Wisdom, and that just makes him almost a semi-carry for late game, even though he's been played as a support. We do have Nake sitting on his armor right now, as well as the Panda on his dagger and on his Arcane Boots. It's just Prophet has his mechanism up, so this is a nice utility Prophet right here that we're seeing out of IG. They realize they do need the mechanism, since we do have one on Funnik, and they're just going for the mechanism on the Prophet with the Hand of Midas in 21 minutes. That's quite decent right now net worth wise. We should take a look at them, and we do see that Prophet is ahead of Kurokai right now by a bit, not too heavily in favor, but you know, still ahead by a little bit. And we do see that Funnik has been caught up by the Nykes, and I don't know if you remember guys, but Nykes, he was totally back and he was out of the game for a while in the first 10 minutes. But Funnik not being able to keep up right now. And we do see that they're getting harassed right now. That means they're gonna see that there's a ward right here. Ward just dropped a little bit too prematurely, means that they know that ward is somewhere else right there and they can't deward that right now. And I do believe that Chavos doesn't have any more sentries right now, yep. Ferrari farming and imposing woods right now, just going really aggressive since Prophet is also split pushing. And I do believe that he's gonna rotate in case they're gonna make any, I do believe IG are gonna look for a go on top lane in case Na'Vi's gonna TP there. I'm gonna be interested if Na'Vi takes a chance or if they're just gonna trade this overall. It looks like a tower trade right now, but Zhao and YYF dealing so much damage right there. Basically the space trade might be even contested by IG. There we see the rotation in by Zhao. Is Zhao gonna do anything? No. right now not. So Na'Vi might be backing off. Or are they going to fight? I mean, we do have the Lina, which has burst damage. We do have all those other heroes that are really, you know, anticipating a fight, and they really want to fight. Obviously, that's the one thing that they can do. As we do have an infested Nyx into Panda, that is a nice, nice combination coming out of them right there as well. Panda obviously has enough mana for his whole combination. It's going to be a big problem to lock him down and kill him off with the Orgul Club in his inventory. Is going to be really hard. There we go, there's the infest right there. He's going to use his primal earth right away. Funnik out of position, might die right here. Kurokai is going to force him back, however they're going to die, and this looks like they're just going to retreat completely. Puppy is going to try to do what he can in this fight. There we do see a power shot coming out from Kurokai from the back line. Danny, however, is not going to be able to do anything right here. Hasn't dropped his dream call, can't do so anyways. Kurokai with a nice shackle shot here on two, but they're not going to survive anything right here. However, Kurokai might be getting out, and yeah, it's gonna get out, I do believe. Nice four step down the high ground right there. YYF porting to prevent her to actually walk away, but four step saving the day for Runeterra right here. And that was an engagement that Na'Vi totally... They blew that engagement, basically, I have to say. 5,000 EXP going in the direction of IG now, and even gold-wise, we're looking ahead. For IG, so this might have been a turning flash right now for Na'Vi. The problem right there was that Funnik didn't deal any damage right there. He doesn't have his Arcanine Scepter up right now. He was standing way too aggressive, and that is just a huge, huge problem for them. As we do see a triple rotation right here with the TPs, and there's the ultimate of Viper slowing down Zhu. Zhou has his Sangon Yasha right now, so he's going to be faster right now. But I do believe with face boots, they might get him. No, they're going to have to abort this chase. And that is a lot of resources being committed right there. Havos and Dandy are both smoked up. Kurokai, however, is in the woods as well as Puppy. They're going to try to get that Prophet. Prophet, however, has a Shadow Blade up now after Mechanism. That means he's going to be able to speed push so well. However, there's the Vendetta Strike with the Impale. Nice Shackle Stop by Kurokai. A lot of damage going out from Kurokai and Puppy. But there's the Mechanism, and they're going to go invisible right here. Do they have any sight? They don't have sight.
Unstoppable.
As we do see on bottom lane, Havos killing off the Lina while Zhou just killed off Lina in return. Havos killing off the Lina, Havos killing off the Silencer. So he's going for that one kill. I guess that's okay for him, trading up kills, getting experience, but overall definitely not what he wants to do without any support. But yeah, Havos standing at 3-4-1, doing what he does best, just killing and not going into fights at all unless he can kill somebody. No, I'm just kidding, obviously. But that is a big problem right now from Na'Vi. Na'Vi's rotation is not 100% perfect, and we do have Funnik still not at his Arcanine Scepter, and he has no damage, he has no ultimate harass in the fights, and obviously if he gets focused out like he did last fight, that is a huge problem for them. Then he's gonna secure a haste room right here. Ferrari is opting towards his Arcanine Scepter. It's gonna still take a while though, as far as I'm concerned. And I do say that, however, he already has his point booster in his inventory. That means he's only sitting 1,500 gold away from his Arcanine Scepter. That is not a whole lot, man. Danny, not able to really go towards the next high tier item, as we do see an initiation on 6. 6, however, is going to use his ultimate form to turn his fight around, and now Puppy is in big problem as well as Danny. Danny's gonna get out, however. That was once again a fight that did not go the way, or a gank that did not go the way of Na'Vi. They almost got the kill, however. There is the Silencer with his global ultimate. Yeah, just preventing anything and even getting a counter kill by that. Man, he survived that really, really closely with not a lot of HP. Anyways, Na'Vi now sitting at 17 to 13. That is a big, big problem for them. They need to check out what they can do. Kurokai, let's look at his items, as we do see a port by him. He's going to be porting back into the base, so nothing too special about that one. I guess he's going to go towards Sheepstick. Definitely a nice item choice for him. It's going to take a little while, though, as far as I'm concerned. He's sitting in 2,300. It's going to be another 2 minutes till he has that, and that is a key item for them for sure. I'm going to have Puppy. Who's going to go for 2 Wraith Bands? Not quite sure what that is about. Increasing the damage of Nyx Assassin, getting more armor in this case. I mean, yeah, he's an agility hero and therefore it's his primary attribute, but I'm not quite sure if this is the right choice item-wise. Funnik now going to look towards a Roshan. Havos stunning up the Roshan, but I do believe that actually no, I'm pretty sure actually that they know. Then he doesn't have a lot of mana and a lot of, I don't know if they can fight this. That's gonna be tough, but IG seems to have not noticed actually. So well done here by Na'Vi, actually securing with a nice D-Wars right here and with the site just securing. They're gonna have an uncontested Roche right here, and that might bring them back into the game just by a bit and maybe give them the chance to turn this fight around. Yep. There we go, it's gonna be picked up by Viper. Definitely the right choice right there. She's gonna have her Arcanim Scepter up in just a moment. Gonna farm those Ancients here right now. And after that, we're gonna see that Arcanim's on her. The question is if that can actually turn something around right here for Na'Vi. I do not know. It's gonna be quite intense and it's gonna be hard for them. Basically because, I mean, yeah, Fanny can use in his teamfight, can use every 12 seconds his ultimate, and it's gonna do a lot of damage and people are gonna be slowed like hell. But the burst damage right now and the clashes, the way they went, the fights are not going to take longer than 20 seconds max. And that means two ultimates off Viper. And, you know, once Viper gets focused down and gets maybe locked down by the global silence of the... oh, this is a problem right there. Of the silencer, I mean, what is Viper going to do? Not a lot. She's not going to carry hard anyways either in this case. So, yeah. I do like Zhou's item build, however. He has opted for Shang and Yasha, increasing his movement speed, increasing his damage, getting a lot of stats in, and also a lot of HP. Also getting a Basher right now, and with the Armament, he is set to fight as much as possible, as much as he wants. And the question is, what is going to happen right now? Because this is going to be almost deciding the next clash. If IG is going to win the next clash, they might even be looking at Rex. However, does have his sheepstick up right now. He's gonna use it, gonna pick up that sheepstick or voidstone at his secret shop. Dendi, where is he sitting at? Is he anywhere near something? Nope, not right now. He does have any. What is he at? Ghost Scepter. Okay. Yeah, why not? Going against that focus from the pandas, that physical right click damage from the Nyx. Not the worst item, but then again, I would have loved what the. Okay, I would have loved to see another sheepstick coming out of Dendi right here. Whatever. Puppy is gonna pick up three Wraith Bands, increasing his armor to 9. Not quite sure if that's worth it. I mean, yeah, he's gonna have a lot of damage with his Vendetta right there, I suppose, but yeah. Well, 400 bonus damage and then the hit right afterwards with the Wraith Band. 100, I mean, that's 500 damage right there. It's not too bad, however, it's not going to kill anybody. Even Silencer is super tanky right now. Prophet sitting at 1500 HP since he's going for a cheap stick soon. Oh man, and even Rubik. Rubik with his, yeah, even Rubik will probably survive a little bit. Oh, maybe, we'll see. I don't know if his solo outtake is possible here of the Nuke's Assassin. Probably, since it's physical damage. I'm gonna see some sort of trade right here. Are they gonna use a rune? They're gonna use a rune. Quick hands right there. That means they're gonna go into the base right there, and Na'Vi needs to care for this. They need to get this tower up, and they're gonna get it. It's gonna be a Kurokai on the wood, and they're gonna get this tower right there. And they're gonna try to defend this, and they're gonna be able to do so because whole of IG just backs up. And they're gonna get a port of the Kravos porting to death mid lane. They suspected this, and they just got the kill right away. That means IG Zo is on a monster kill right now, sitting at 10-1. Man, that was not the best port of Havos's life, and that means that this is going to be a huge problem for Na'Vi right there. 4-5, I mean, the question is, what is IG going to do right now? I mean, they have the one disadvantage right now, that Viper has the Aegis, but I do believe that doesn't even matter that much. They can focus Viper down once she revives, and they're going to finish off the rest of the team immediately. And they're going to smoke into the base right here, it seems, and there we go. Puppy is going to get killed immediately right there, going to get surprise ganked. And that means that IG is gonna take another life of Na'Vi. That means Havos is still not there. You do see Fnatic going in with his ultimate. That means he's gonna have his ultimate up. No, he doesn't. Where is his? He opted for BKB. Maybe the right choice in this case. Not the Arcanim Scepter. Just a casual point booster. But look at that. He's not dealing any damage right now. That's a big, big problem for them. Zhao here is gonna be more or less Kai. However, the Rex is gonna drop. Havos is gonna be hammered down. Dendi is in the middle of the fight. He's gonna get killed immediately by a stolen impale as well as the damage from everybody, and there we go. There's the ultimate from Panda, and my god, Na'Vi is getting shredded completely right now. Wow. Funny, he's gonna revive from his Aegis, so one thing they have. Are they gonna chase down somebody? Are they gonna get a kill? Faith is actually gonna be sheep down by Kurkai. They're gonna get a kill on Six. Are they gonna also get a kill on Faith? Chavos is gonna go for Faith, obviously, because he knows his other mate or his mates are gonna kill down the Rubick for sure. But Faith, man, he's mobile, and that checker shot is not gonna connect, sadly, for Kurkai. However, they have 4 staffs, they have enough mobility, and that's why they get another kill on IG right there. So 20-16. Is Navi gonna make a comeback right here? That's the big question. Can they actually afford to do so? They're behind 7,500 gold and 7,500 EXP as well, which is quite a lot. Puppy still having his wraith band stacked up. We do see Dagger now coming out for her loss. Very aggressive item. The question is Navi in the position to get this aggressive item? I would have loved to see another 4-staff right here, because I do believe 4-staff is more mobile. I'm sure you cannot Dagger anywhere, but then again, as you can see, she's getting picked up by anybody right now. Well, yeah, what I wanted to say is basically, you know, getting a 4-staff on Lina means when you're getting attacked, you can still try to get out, and that is definitely worth something in this game, because right now we do not see Navi playing aggressive, well, except for a mid-early game. Right now it is actually IG who's gonna pressure, and then you're picking up a double damage rune right here. 900 gold in his stash, not enough for any items right now. Ogrecrop going towards Fnatic. Fnatic gonna go for the Aghanims after BKB. Man, he is tanky, but man, you saw in the last fight, he was right-clicking the lifesteal, and lifesteal didn't lose any health. Prophet didn't lose any health. Really, I do believe that Viper in this game would have needed some nice damage. Maybe a Sang and Yasha, maybe a Manta style, something after the mechanism to just follow up. BKB sure is a nice item, but Fnatic had some really decent farm early game. So you see Kurkai picking up a Helm of Dominator right now, so going for a life lead, just gonna go for a carry build overall now, maybe gonna opt for some more damage items, maybe an MKB to follow up. But yeah, Fnatic with that farm and gold advantage, I do believe that would have been so awesome. As we do see initiation on Kurkai, Kurkai is gonna turn around, shackle shot, nice shackle by him. IG Zoe is sort of isolated from his team, but he's gonna be back, and now the question is Navi gonna make the mistake to engage here? They shouldn't, they definitely shouldn't. They already used their first surprise attack right there, and they are still behind, so they need to care. And there's I mean, Panda has his ultimate form up, he can primal split at any point. They're gonna smoke up. Interesting. Oh yeah, as I said, Fnatic with farm advantage, if he gets damage and they pressure early game like they could have with their picks, I do believe this game might have gone a different way, because Navi could have just traded the towers down, or I guess take the towers. I mean, IG would have not been able to trade as fast as Navi could have pressured, and they couldn't have fought as well. Another Shaxxer going up by Kurkai. You're not gonna latch, however. There we go, another Blink Dagger initiation with a follow-up Primal Split right there. Chavos is gonna get killed immediately. Not gonna be able to Laguna Blade anywhere. Big problem once again for Navi. No 4-staff, my friend. Dad's just gonna kill you. Kurukai gonna wound run out right now. Puppy's gonna be fine. Is Denny gonna get out? That's a big question. No, Denny's gonna get killed off at the backside. And there's Fnatic being rotated up by Cyclone. And man, this guy really poor life for Fnatic. He's gonna go down as well. Not gonna deal any damage, not gonna tank any damage. And overall, I do believe Fnatic has no chance to carry this game. There we do see the GG call right there. So man, Navi, after a promising start in the early game laning phase, gonna get basically destroyed. Basically getting destroyed by that one telekinesis on the bottom lane. I mean, if he doesn't get lifted on that cliff, I do believe that we would have seen a nice try lane, nice domination by Navi. But in this case, we didn't see that, because Puppy had to chill on a cliff for 2 minutes, and that broke their early game, to be honest. And even though a nice game plan with Fnatic right there, going for the wrong items after all, after the mecha, no damage for him, and therefore no capability to clash really hard. And this is going to be a good game. Right there, IG taking the first game versus Navi. And Navi is going to have to look to improve their gameplay for the playoffs, which are coming up this Saturday. So be aware of it. Tune in. A lot of people are going to cast that. And I hope you enjoyed this cast. And yeah, that's it. See you guys.